Hello friends, greetings from Adhikari Education and AssamExam.com. This is part 5 video of the 2016 GS paper analysis and suggested topic for 2018 prelim. In this video, we will cover from question number 41 to question 50 of set C of 2016 GS paper. So, we will start with the session now. So, question 41, you can see what like the question was. Which of the following was the first English newspaper in India that was published in 1780? So you can see all the options are there. All the options are like correct name of English journals, and the correct answer is Bengal Gazette. It was started by Hickey. So it is also known as Hickey's Bengal Gazette or original Calcutta General Advertiser. It was a weekly newspaper, definitely published from Calcutta. And that weekly newspaper was Critics of Administration of Warren Hastings. Warren Hastings was the Governor General, and his administration policies were criticized in that newspaper. And it used to fight for free expression, freedom of press. So this question is very much from Indian history, and that is also particularly what was the scenario of press, the emergence of press during the British rule in India. So what can be other suggested topic related to these questions? It can be when Lord Lytton was the Governor General, he wanted to regulate vernacular presses. Vernacular presses means all the dailies and all presses that are not in English, other than English, like in local language. These are called vernacular languages. So he wanted to regulate all vernacular languages presses. That's why he has also passed one act called Vernacular Press Act in 1878. Then J.S. Buckingham also started one journal called Calcutta Journal. It is actually the second one. First one was Bengal Gazette, second one was Calcutta Journal. It was started in 1818. Then other famous journals are also there. This thing also you should see, the Bengali Amrit Bazar Patrika, which is still in publication, and these are in Bengali. Now Amrit Bazar Patrika is in English also. Then some others were also there, Sambad Kaumadi, Miratul Akbar, Rust Goftar, Indian Mirror, Bombay Samachar, Hindu Patriot, The Hindu, Kesari, Hitavadi, then Vande Matram, all those magazines, popular newspaper and magazines, whatever was published that time. Those are important things, from where it was published, what was the language in which it was published, and who has started. So those most important things you should know. Any question can come from those areas. Okay, we'll move to the next question. This question is about who has succeeded Robert Clive to lead East India Company. You can say Robert Clive was the first administrator who was the pioneer in establishing British rule in India. He was basically from army background. He has fought so many wars in India. He has won so many with Indian local ruler and with French also. That's he has set one of the you can say significant foundation for British administration in India. So you can see these options are there. Out of all those options, Lord Warren Hastings. Lord Hastings, it is given C. So it is the correct answer is Lord Warren Hastings. So first is Robert Clive, then Warren Hastings. From Warren Hastings, it goes on list will be long list of governor, then the main governor general. And then after 1857, revolt of 1857, they changed the post to Viceroy. Okay, then we will see Robert Clive is very important. So on Robert Clive, so many important significance is there. Important question can come. You should know something about him. He was the first Governor General of Bengal. He was he is from army. So he was the Commander in Chief of British India. Then he was part of he has led so many wars in India. He has won so many wars in India. In Carnatic War, first Carnatic War, then Pondicherry. He has snatched Pondicherry from French for some time. Then Arcot also he has snatched from some other rulers. Then Battle of Plassey, he was the leader of British army. Then Battle of Condore. He has also another important thing what he has done is he was the person who got the Farman from Shah Alam, that Mughal Emperor, for for being the Diwan of Bengal, Bihar and Odisha region. So that was like you can say the first provision, and after from which they get the administrative power in some region of India. So this was the first foundation of British administration in India. So this is all about this question. Based on this question, what can be expected topic? Expected topic can be like all important governor generals, who were the initial governor generals, governors, all those things, viceroy, everything. Then Warren Hastings is also one of the like very important earlier leader, administrator of British, who has like helped in setting foundation of British administration in India. So those things you should know. We'll move to the next question. This question is about this question ask about the founder. Who was the founder? Like they have told the founder, Job Charnock was the founder of Calcutta, and where it was like founded, at the site of what are the locations. But actually this question is wrong. Outrightly this question is wrong, because Calcutta High Court had a ruling in 2003, and they have specifically told like Job Charnock cannot be considered as a founder of Calcutta. So the question, first statement is wrong. But in examination, even if the question is wrong, as a aspirant, you can't go for, you don't have any option. You have to take an option. That the only option is, you have four options. Out of that, you have to take one option. So out of all the these four options given, correct answer is D. So all the three sites are like, all the three sites are part of Calcutta, which we know today. So all the three sites are inside the Calcutta only. So correct answer is D, but the answer question was technically wrong. So either APSC should not have asked these questions. Okay, so we'll leave all those things. What can be the suggested topic based on this one? Suggested topic can be like, who are the people, first time who are the people came from outside in India, you can say. In modern history, it will be like modern or medieval period. Vasco da Gama, Robert Clive, also one of the first. Though he has not come for the first time in India, as the first British in India, but they were the people who has came the earliest, and they were like very influential in setting the trend for the future. So Robert Clive, Warren Hastings. Then you can also see this question also ask about like history of Calcutta. So it's one of the presidency in British India. It was one of the presidency. So whatever we can focus also on history of all other presidencies like Bombay, Madras. Then we can other areas like Delhi, Pondicherry, Goa, Mosulipatnam, Cuddalore. So these are the areas like which were stronghold of all those European imperialists who has came to India. So you should know some history about those areas also. This is like a related question. Related question can be framed from those areas. Okay, we'll move to the next question. This is from World Geography. Climate. Seasonal reversal of winds is the typical characteristics of which of the following climate? So we are having equatorial climate is there, Mediterranean climate is there, monsoon climate is there, and all of the above. So they are asking about seasonal reversal of winds. So on some season, winds direction changes in which of the following climate? The answer is monsoon climate. Normally in equatorial climate, it is said that 365 days their climate is same. So you know it will not be equatorial climate, so there is no seasonal change and all. So in monsoon climate, like some characteristic is there, their temperature will be around 18. Then you can see all other thing, where it will be like normally where it is found, South and Central America, Southeast Asia, South Asia, all Africa, Caribbean, all those places. Based on this, some related topic we can have is, climate is categorized into some, like, based on so many parameters, some classification is there. So Köppen climate classification is one of the classification. You should see this one also, so many classification you will find. Then some other like four types of forest, what based on in every forest, what are the typical and commonly found flora and fauna, those things we should know. Then like we have discussed in the previous video also, some other important topic like El Nino, La Nina, South Oscillation, those topics are always important from climatology and all those point of view. Okay, we'll move to the next question. 45 question is about like Tirupur. Tirupur is a place in Tamil Nadu. So they are asking about like, this is famous for which of the following product? Tirupur is actually very famous, like you can say it is there, like very much producing almost very significant portion of one goods for the whole India, you can say. So cotton knitted garment is the correct answer. Out of all those things, knitted garment is the correct answer. They are exporting about 90% of India's total knitwares. So when they are exporting 90% of India's total export, so you know it's very significant. Like their production amount is very significant as compared to whole India. So Tirupur, it is in Tamil Nadu, as I told. It is also known as knitwear capital of India. They are having around 4 lakh workers. They have so many like textile industries are there nearby. Industrial parks are there. This is from Indian economy, you can say. So based on this one, what can be some other suggested topic? Some other suggested topic, some other centers of industrial production, where like any good is produced in like in majorly it is produced in those specific areas, like in Surat, diamond polishing, diamond cutting. So in whole India, you can say most of the works are related to diamonds cutting and diamond polishing happens in Surat. So they are specialized for one particular thing, but they produce almost 100%, you can say 80%, 90%. Then so many hand loom centers will be there, those things you should know. Then as in with respect to Assam, so many like hand loom centers are there, silk works are there, tea areas are, tea producing areas are there, brass metal works are there. So what are the centers? Swalkuchi is one of the area that you know. So this like that questions of like concentrated area of industrial production, those centers we should know. We'll move to the next question. Eightfold path of Buddha is known as middle path because what is the exact reason? So Buddha's path is known as middle path. Why? So if you see all the options, the correct answer is avoid self-indulgence and self-immolation. Jainism and all, they focus very much in self-immolation. Like the other worldliness, they are not materialistic, they are the opposite side of materialism. But in Buddhism, they say it is the middle path. Like we should not be too much materialistic and we should not be too much otherworldly nature also. We should not think everything will happen after this life. We should also think about what is happening in this life. So it's a combination. Middle in this teaching is also called as noble eightfold path, that which leads to liberation. In every religion there will be a path for liberation. This is the path in Buddhism. So on this eightfold paths are like some principles are right understanding, right thought, right speech, right action, right livelihood, right effort, right mindfulness and right concentration. So based on this, you can see this question is Indian history, but it is mostly related to philosophy, religious philosophies and all. So suggested topic can be definitely Buddhism, Jainism is there, then in Hinduism and Sanatan Dharma, this Vedas is there, then Bhakti movement is there, then ancient this Vaishnavism is there. Vaishnavism is also having four sampradayas, like four classes, four divisions are there in Vaishnavism. Those things also like important, they can ask those. Then some school of thoughts are also there. So this is the like philosophy, historic religious philosophy. Mostly it will be Indian originated religious philosophy, but they can ask about some like Islam and Christianism, though they are not Indian originated, but question can come from those religious philosophy also. Okay, we'll move to the next question. Which party was founded by Subhash Chandra Bose in the year 1939? So we know, so like the correct answer is Forward Bloc. In 1939, when he was for the second time, he was elected for as president of the Indian National Congress. Some other people didn't like it, and somehow he had to resign, and he came out of Indian National Congress. Then he has formed one separate political organization that is called Forward Bloc. It was a left-wing, leftist, it was more to toward leftism. Then that's it. After that, he went to Singapore and for establishment of Indian force, Azad Hind force, and all those things. So he was not much active in this political organization after some time. But it was in the name of the same name, one political party was re-established after independent, but it is not very significant now. So based on this question, what are the other topic we can expect in 2018? Definitely political parties and political organization during the India's freedom struggle. Then so many facts about Indian National Congress, other Hindu Mahasabha, United Patriotic Association. United Patriotic Association, actually it was formed with encouragement from Britishers, and Britishers wanted to counteract the actions taken by Indian National Congress. That's why they formed this United Patriotic Association. Then some other parties are also there, Communist Party, Revolutionary Socialist Party, then so many parties are there. So those parties also you should know when it was started, who was if it was started by some significant leader, significant political freedom fighters, then you should know this thing. Question can come from those areas also. We'll move to the next question. The doctrine of non-violence and civil disobedience associated with Mahatma Gandhi were influenced by these options are there. So you can see so many options. The correct answer, it is a tough question. Correct answer is Ruskin, Tolstoy, and Thoreau. So it's about the strategies that Gandhi has used. So many strategies Gandhi has used in his non-violence way of this one freedom fight. He has used Satyagraha, non-cooperation. Then this against untouchability also he has practiced so many good policies. He used to call them Harijan, all those words. Then so based on this one, what can be the our expected question? So philosophy is, what was the thinking behind so many movement came, so many groups of people, so many groups of people has participated in India's freedom fight, but everyone has contributed in their own way, in their own thinking. Extremists are there, they were more violent. Moderates are there, they were more non-violent. So different people are participating in their own way. So what is the philosophy? Then communists are there, Muslim League was there, Hindu nationalists are there. So communists are more of leftist, Muslim League, Hindu nationalists are more of religious centric. Then movement of freedoms, all those so many movements of freedom struggle. Then what are the what are the movements Gandhi has started? All those topics are, you can say these can be related from this question. So you can expect some question from these areas in the upcoming exam. So we'll move to the next question. Chief Minister of all the states are ex officio members of which of the following organization or body? So we know it is National Development Council. Planning Commission is now here. Finance Commission is there, but ministers are not there. Interstate Council also. CMs are there, but Interstate Council may not have all the state. So because the question is asking about Chief Minister of all the states. So the question is about federal, it is from Indian polity, specifically federal structure, how the federal organization, all the states, how all the states coordinate. So suggested topic can be, now because planning commission is scrapped, Niti Aayog is there. It is, and they will say Niti Aayog is for development of federalism in India. So we should know about Niti Aayog, Interstate Council. Then for in Northeast, Northeastern Council is there, Northeast Council is there. That one also we should know. Then Finance Commission is there. That is also for federal, the promotion of federalism, specifically financial federalism. What amount should be distributed from center to the states. Okay, we'll move to the next question. area wise, which of the following is the largest Lok Sabha constituency? So they are asking about the largest Lok Sabha constituency. Correct answer is Ladakh. Ladakh is having a very big area, but because number of people are very less, density is very less in Ladakh because of this height and inevitable like climate is there. It is very cold. That's why number of people are very less, and so the area is bigger and constituency for one Lok Sabha constituency. So the question is from Indian Polity, we all know. So based on this, what can be the suggested topic for the upcoming exam? It can be all the Lok Sabha, about the Lok Sabha constituencies, Rajya Sabha constituencies. For Lok Sabha constituencies, which state is having more number of Lok Sabha constituencies, which states are having minimum number of Lok Sabha constituencies. For Rajya Sabha constituencies, like some criteria are there, which may one member to be elected from a state, what should be his criteria, any member, whether only for a particular, any member from a particular state can be appointed from same state only or some other state. So criteria are there for Rajya Sabha constituency, and it is different from Lok Sabha constituency. So we should know this thing also. Then there is a commission called Delimitation Commission. So this commission is for redrawing the boundary of constituencies. They are also like constituted after every couple of decades. Normally after every couple of decades it was constituted. Then this thing only. Then we can also think about, we can also see some legislative assemblies, constituency also, how many constituencies are there. So these are the expected topic related to this particular question. With this one we'll conclude this part 5. Part 6 will cover question from 51 to 60 that will be released very soon. And for now that's it. For all the regular videos related to APSC and all other exam preparation, you can subscribe to our channel Adhikari Education by clicking on the bell icon in the right side corner of the video. Thank you.